Hello and welcome to another special edition of Midday's Masterclass. Our sport today is table tennis. Indian table tennis is going through one of its best phases at the moment, with 8 medals at the Commonwealth Games last year and 2 medals at the Asian Games. So to understand the nuances and the finer points of the sport, we have with us 8-time national champion and a legend of the sport in India, Mr. Kamlesh Mehta. So welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Sir, can you tell us about how the sport has changed from the time that you have played?
Well, this is one of the sports which has actually evolved a lot. I mean, in every aspect it has changed. From what I was playing till now, the scoring pattern, we used to have 21 points game, best of 5 was the maximum. And then a service was 5 services per player, and then it was changed. It has changed from there to now 11 points, best of 5 and best of 7, and 2 services per player. The size of the ball has also changed. During our time it was 38 mm and the ball, now it's 40 mm and even 40 mm plus. We had celluloid ball, now it's plastic ball. The color of the table was always green, now we have multiple color, blue, black. The flooring was always wooden flooring, but now we have synthetic flooring which is also of different color. When I started playing, it was more of single color t-shirts that we used to have, and that too dark color. Now we have a lot of design, a lot of variety coming up, and that has added color to the game. Basically the technique, even the rackets, the rubbers, the kind of play on the table has totally changed. It has now become attacking, very attacking right from the first ball. So it's more of attacking and counter attacking. Lot of power has been involved. The physical fitness requirement is also much higher. I would say that it is covering everything. So each and every aspect of the game has gone into a change. So that's the reason a player who is doing well in all this, in spite of all these changes, really shows a lot of adaptability on the player's point of view.
Since the game is also booming across India, can you tell us the initiatives at the grassroots level? You think enough has been done to promote this game?
Well, now with a lot of grassroots level activities are taking place, you can see a lot of NGOs, a lot of private players also coming in. It's a good thing. Earlier, most of the grassroots level was left to SGFI, School Games Federation of India, which used to conduct, that was one of the first tournaments that I also participated. And that happens from taluka level in almost all sport. But now every federation, every state association also has realized broad-basing the sport. And that is done at the school level. For example, 11 Sports is our company. We have done in table tennis, grassroots level pan-India inter-school program in almost 24 states. So that is one of the thing. But government also is doing a lot for the grassroots. Now they are coming up with Khelo India, which is focusing on youth and the futuristic players. Then they are also having this open event now started 13 to 15 years of age, where anybody can participate in any sport and then they will select from them. So these grassroots activities are moving on, and people have realized that in India, sports has to grow, then grassroots has to be broader. However, there's always scope to do much more, and I would say that government does a lot. In India, government is probably the major supporter of sport.
So we have some promising players, and they have some questions for you regarding table tennis and how they can improve their game.
My name is Shravani Loke. I'm a national level player. How important is a serve, and can you tell us the importance of receiving?
Yes, a very nice question, Shravani. See, table tennis game starts with service or receiving. 50% of the time you are serving, 50% time you are receiving. So the start is very important. If you do an easy serve, then the opponent will finish it. So important of service is not only controlling but having a lot of variation. As you know, in table tennis there are so many kind of services, forehand services, backhand services, banana services, so various kind of services, and along with service there are different kind of spins. So service practice is very important. So I would say that if you are practicing for 2 hours, you must at least give 25% time of yours to doing variety of services and putting a different place on the table. We normally divide the table into 9 spots, and you should be able to serve a particular kind of service on all the 9 spots whenever you want. So that is one thing about service, because that is the only time when everything is under your control. Once you have served, the everything depends upon how the opponent reacts. So service is most important, and if you see the topmost players, those who are there, they generally survive at that level and become champions is because they have very good serves. So in table tennis, serve is one thing that you cannot neglect. Even if you have good strokes and not a good serve, it's going to be more difficult for you to maintain. Now I'm going to demonstrate a good serve. So important point is not only a good serve but a correct serve. So first and foremost, for anything is a good stance. So how you stand, you have to decide where to stand. For a serve, you should be standing as near to the table as you can. Standing away or standing too far away is not an advantage, it's a disadvantage. So first thing is good stance. I'm doing a high toss forehand serve, which is the most commonly used serve. Here you should have your left leg, if you're a right hander, your left leg should be in front and the right behind, but your balance should be very good. Second, how to hold the ball. The ball has to be on the palm, center of your palm, not your fingers like this, but it should be straight and the thumb slightly away. Both the racket and the ball should be above the table surface and outside the end line. Why I'm saying is, what is the correct service? Before you serve, all you need to do, you should be aware where the opponent is standing and what he's ready for. Before you start and the action of the entire service, you should be very clear what kind of service you're going to do and where, and what is the probable receive. So you are more ready for that. So first I'll say, when you start the serve, your knees should be bent. You watch the opponent from the side of your eye. Your racket has to be between the thumb and the first forefinger, and it should be loose, it should be very tight, because if you are tight you cannot generate spin. So to generate spin, it should be very loose, but not so loose that anybody touches it falls down. It should be firm but loose. Here the action, the elbow will be slightly away from the body. If you keep it close to the body, you'll get cramped. So keep your elbow away from the body. Toss the ball straight. You have to toss at least minimum 6 inches and hit the ball when it's falling. You cannot hit the ball on the top of the ball when you're, it is a wrong service. Now when the ball is coming down, where to hit the ball? The point of contact is the most important thing. Your tossing should be such that it should be coming near your body. And from here, you also bend down and hit as nearer to the table so that the time getting for the opponent to react is less and the control is better and the ball will be net level. So this is a few things that you need to take care. I'll just demonstrate here when I'm hitting the ball down, so it goes net level. So here the kind of spin will also depend upon how you hit the ball and where you hit the ball. The one that I hit was a backspin with side spin, as the ball went on the side. The same action I can also generate a forward spin where the ball will jump forward. You can see this from here. It jumps forward. So that's a forward spin. The very little use of variation is what you'll get the variation in your service. And this is what needs a lot of practice, that in very little change and there's an entirely difference in the spin. And this is where I'll say that deception is what you need to practice for. So again I'll show, you see the action is, I gave a side spin, then I can give you an, this is a reverse spin, and the place also can be varied. That is where you need practice, but entire thing remains the same of you starting till the end. Only at the point of contact all this variation takes place. Similarly, we can do it for backhand service. Now, why do a backhand service? You should have variety of service, because if you have only same type of service, opponent will read you and then you will not have the advantage of surprise. To have an advantage of surprise, here's the backhand. If you see, the backhand position is entirely different, where my right leg is in front instead of the left leg, and here I stand crossed, and this is where I do. The same thing will follow of tossing the ball, hitting the ball near the table, and then variation is old by use of wrist. Your wrist again should be loose, and here, because if it is loose, you can generate more spin and you can do variation. If it is tight, then very little variation can be done. So I'll just demonstrate how, and this is also very quick action I take, so that it doesn't give the opponent much time. So here, you see, very quick brushing. The same thing can be done even for deception, is doing a long service. If I am making a long action, the opponent will read it. So all you need to, important part besides knowing how to do the spin, is the deception. Same action, trying to create different kind of services. we just touched service, now I'm going to tell something about receiving. It is as important as service because 50% of the game depends on receiving and starts with receiving for a player. Whenever you are receiving, first is the stance. You stand in a very attentive position, both the arms above the table. The reason is that it saves a lot of time. If your arm is down, it will take, you have to come up and then go. That takes a lot of time, and that is the time that we don't have in table tennis. And your eyes are fixed on the service, the opponent point of contact, because from the point of contact when the ball touches the racket, it's where I can actually know what kind of spin has been given on the serve. And that is very important, because if I have to be a good receiver, I must first understand the spin that has been given, and that can be made out from the action of the opponent and the point of contact when the ball and the bat are meeting each other of the opponent. So here, keep your hand in front and straight, and you have to watch the opponent. The moment the point of contact happens, take your right leg in front and head always down. So many people get up like this and then go. Here you lose your control and the use as well as visibility. So not to do that, you should keep your eyes almost over the net, keep your hand little loose so that you can just do a soft touch receiving, because in receiving is more of touch. So now she'll do a short service and I'll just demonstrate. The ball has gone slightly high. So what I do is I have to angle my bat. So my angle was this. All I need to do is slight change in the action of the angle and the ball will go low. This will go low. If I have to do even shorter, then more soft touch. I have to do long, then I have to be a little harder. This a little bit hard hit, the ball will go longer. And here I can also flick. And the new thing is banana flick. Here I can play an aggressive receiving. Well, I can generate a spin on this. So this is the latest thing that one has to develop if one has to become a better player. Okay. So this is the banana flick, which is the aggressive receiving, and that has to be developed. Now she will do a high toss service, which is a little different service, and then you can do your long on the backhand, and how backhand opening receiving also can be done. Do a high toss service. I am doing a backhand attacking stroke because it's a long service. I read the spin and then immediately a quick action, because you don't get much time in service because it comes as surprise. And reading the spin, I adjust my angle. And that's how the same thing can be done with forehand. But attacking strokes is a top spin play will come into when receiving, when it is a long service. So these are the two aspects which you should actually give 50% of your training time to focus on. You have to practice daily because it's a skill. The more you practice, the more sharper you become.
India is rising in table tennis. So what was done earlier as compared to what is being done now? So what is the change? What is the difference?
The difference, I would say that first I'll go into what was been done during our time. Our time, the coverage was, what coverage we had was in newspaper. There was not much of television. There was no social media. Any information about a hero was not available to us. We would be having international exposure maybe 2 events in a year. Our season would be only about 4 months. So there was hardly any international exposure. We could not even go out for training. We didn't have any information about it. But today, if you go to see, right from 12 years of age, children and parents are taking out time and sending the children for international tournaments. Government and the federation, especially Table Tennis Federation I can speak of, they have made this change and have allowed young players to go abroad and participate in the junior circuit. Now we have senior circuit, junior circuit, then hope circuit. So they have various circuit with their regular tournaments are being held where it encouraged. Now even we have gone up to veteran circuit, that is 40 plus circuit also, because there's a huge population of 40 plus players who are playing actively table tennis. So we have various circuits which was not there during our time. It was only Asian Championship, World Championships, that too once in 2 years, etc. And we hardly had any other exposure. But now the exposure is huge. So they are able to learn the nuances and the best things of the game much earlier. at the young age. So they have the vision at a very young age, and this helps them to grow and to look up more. Plus, one person can go and train abroad. The information about training camps abroad are available. The interaction between foreign players and Indian players have also increased. Our Indian players have started doing well now, and the government support is also increasing. So these are the changes I can say have played a very important role in table tennis coming to this level that we see now.
I am Virendra Dandekar from Jawaharlal Nehru Vidyalaya, Palghar. Could you please demonstrate and show us the crucial role of topspin in table tennis? And parallel to that, what is the importance of receiving topspin?
If you ask anybody today, if you want to be a champion, which is a stroke that you should definitely be strong on, obviously it is topspin. So topspin is a stroke which is attacking stroke. You can play from forehand, you can play from any side of the table with forehand, or you can even play with backhand. And topspin is one stroke which can be played on anything. It can be played on a backspin, it can be played on long service, it can be played after receiving, it can be played on topspin, it can be played on counter, it can be played on block also. So this is one stroke which can be played on any stroke at all. And so like for every stroke that you have, there is an answer in topspin. Forehand topspin is what we'll say as this is one of the most important stroke in modern table tennis. If you want to become a champion, topspin has to be mastered and practiced again, again, again and again. I mean, it's like repetition thousands and thousands of times. This is what we play is a forehand counter. The same thing like topspin. Here I'm just showing you in action, but important point again is the point of contact and the full body going forward. So when the ball comes, you hit hard, hit hard, hit hard. That forehand topspin, the ball will come at different places also. In modern table tennis can also be played, and it goes up to 150 kilometers an hour, and it goes along with the rotation, and you can have two kind of spins. One is a forward spin and a side spin together, and that's why this stroke is very difficult to counter.
We see Indian players now competing well against Chinese players who are known for their attacking style. How Indian players have worked to attack the best?
Again, I'll go back during our time, like German Bundesliga is one of the best, is considered a mecca of table tennis. Every player would dream to play in Bundesliga. During my time, I had an opportunity to play in the Italian league as well as the German league. However, our rules did not permit me to go and take that assignment. But now, over a period of time, federation and the government, everything is made much easier for our players to go and be part of this Bundesliga, because that is where the best players of the world come and play. And when you train with them, table tennis being a skill game, it's not only just practicing amount, but practicing with those players who are the top and getting to learn from them in practical. Theoretical is one thing, but in practical, actually feeling it on table is what helps you. They are training with them, talking to them. For example, UTT, Ultimate Table Tennis League. It's a unique league, which is a only short form league where there are foreign players and the Indian players. The idea was that our Indian players stay 21 days with the top players, train with them, be a part of them, discussion, strategizing, practicing with them, and getting them to play with them has helped them a lot. Similarly, if you are there for 9 months in Bundesliga, it will help you so much. And that's what exactly has happened. Chetan Babur was there. Sarath Kamal has actually made a difference. He was there. He's been playing in Bundesliga for many, many years, and you can see the achievements. Satyan is also going there. We have Amal Raj playing in Polish league. We have Harmit, who has played in Swedish league. Ghosh, who has played in... So more and more players, even younger players, and now even women players are going. So that's a very good change, and I would say this is what is actually helping our Indian players to come up to a level. I would say that we still below the Chinese, but we are there now. We have got two players in the top 50 we never had. Even woman Manika Batra was in top 15. So basically, participation in foreign leagues, exposure with them, having foreign coaches, having the individual foreign coaches also has helped our players to improve their standard. And now they have won a medal in Asian Games, two bronze medal in Asian Games in Asia. In table tennis, Asia is like world. So winning a Asian Games medal is all very, very near to winning an Olympic medal as well.
Myself, Omkar, I have played SJ5 from NVS State. My question is, Manika Batra used pimple racket. Can you say more about it?
Yes, that's a good question, because in table tennis, rubber plays a very important role. So whenever you're selecting your equipment, you should be very choosy and selective. So this is a racket. The racket has a rubber on each side, and it's compulsory to have one side red and one side black. Now this is the plain rubber. As you can feel it, it's absolutely smooth. So we call it plain rubber. And on this side, as you see, there are some pimples on it. So this is short pimple. In pimple, we have two kind of. One is short pimple, where the size of the pimple is small. And this has some different qualities than the plain rubber. Majority of the players in the around the world use plain rubber. There are many players who use this pimple rubber. And this pimple rubber has its advantages and disadvantages. The advantage is that it can help you get better control, but the disadvantage is that it can do very limited spin amount. You cannot generate spin on your own. It all depends upon what spin is given. It gives back that spin too. The other one is long pimple. If you sideways, if you see, the pimple are slightly longer. This long pimple rubbers are also known as a funny rubber or the magic rubber. Why these names have come? Because when it was invented or when it was first implemented by the Chinese and the Japanese, the ball used to behave in a very funny manner, which was very difficult for the opponent to understand. In table tennis, when any stroke is played, from the action of the stroke, the opponent determines what kind of spin or what kind of speed you are doing. But in this funny rubber, whatever action you do, the spin generated on the ball is entirely opposite. Now, Manika Batra on one side is using the plain rubber and the other side is using the long pimple rubber. So, the advantage of long pimple which she has is that she plays from near the table and it upsets the opponent. Because of this variation, the opponent has to be more sharper and she can use that for variation. And the moment she plays the ball, the opponent goes little bit on a defensive and she can always turn and take the initiative to attack. But Manika Batra has actually done a good job because she is tall and she is using the long pimple being close to the table, and she has mastered and practiced a lot so that using the different surface, different point of contact on the bat to generate a different kind of spin. And importantly, she has got the control to play the long pimple, because long pimple, easier to say that it's very magical, but it needs lot of practice to control it, and which Manika has been able to do that, has successfully done it. As a result, you can see the result that she has done given in table tennis.
So it is funny, but it can be dangerous.
Yes, it is funny. It can be advantageous, but it can also be disadvantageous if you are not having good control over it.
My name is Pearl Amal Sadiwala. I am a national level player. My question is, how important is backhand in modern table tennis, and can you please demonstrate for us?
During our time, we used to play table tennis more with forehand. Backhand was more of a stroke for continuing the rally or a defensive kind of stroke. We would push or a block. Rarely would be using backhand to attack, or once in a while when the high ball comes, you would use it for hitting hard. But backhand was more of a for continuing the rally. All the attacking strokes would be played by forehand. So the importance of forehand was very high, and even that time we had lot of penhold players which coming from Asia. At that time penhold players was considered to be advantageous, but over a period of time, now the game of table tennis has become very fast, very aggressive. It's becoming difficult for anybody, even with the fitness of the Chinese and the Koreans who are genetically also very strong and do lot of fitness, to play the entire table with forehand. And with this double flank attack coming into play in late 1970s, when the Hungarian developed this backhand topspin and backhand attack, which not many players were using that much, the importance of backhand actually increased, because playing the entire table with forehand was practically not possible to dominate. The only player who is right now doing that well is Zhu Jin, but those exceptional players are very, very few. But he also has developed a backhand in spite of being a penhold player. So backhand is so important. It's like that if you want to be a top player, without a good backhand, it's going to be two or three times more difficult and more harder for you. Because the game has become so fast, now the backhand topspin also has become very important. Now backhand topspin can be started on a push, can be played on a counter. So I'll start off with push. When the ball is rising, important thing is, you try to meet the ball in front going forward when the ball is rising. Because when the ball is rising, it becomes easier for you to hit with more power. This is for on the chop. Now if I have to hit continuously, So after when I hit, you block, and when I hit in on a chop, I am nearer to the table. But when it comes out, I have to go a little behind and play. So we'll demonstrate both of this. Open, and then the second one, you see, I have to hit with angle down. The first one, I am lifting the ball. Second, I am hitting it down. So these two things has to be practiced separately, because both the situations are different. The spin that is on the ball is different.
Table tennis as a sport is also quite popular among other sports. You know, like, it's a known fact that Sachin Tendulkar is really good at table tennis. So can you tell us, like, how does it help in hand-eye coordination, sighting the ball? What are the benefits of playing table tennis?
As you rightly said, table tennis is a sport. There are various advantages. One is, it can be played anytime. Any time of the day, any time of the year, because it doesn't require much of an infrastructure to start off playing for fun. Of course, for competitive, it is very difficult. And the best part of it is that it gives you very good reflex, eye-hand coordination, control. In any sport, if you want to do well, one is control and speed. So you increase your reflex, and reflex helps you in almost all sport, because you need to take decisions very fast. So table tennis is one sport where the ball travels in seconds many times, and it comes in, and you have to put in a very small area of 4.5 by 5. So basically this thing helps at a higher level, I would say, little, if you're playing a little better, like Sachin plays a lot, it helps you in footwork. So that, you know, that one step, two steps footwork, this helps you in cricket, because cricket, the ball comes from farther out, but this is a smaller ball, comes much faster and a shorter distance. And when the ball comes, bigger ball from a longer distance, it always helps you to have a lot of time to react. And this is the basic thing, I would say, that everybody generally tells that if you are playing any sport, but you should also play table tennis, because it will help you increase your speed and reflex.
My name is Ananya Chandi. I'm a national level table tennis player. And my question is, how do you defend against an attacking player?
Right from beginning, if you go to see now, right from service receiving, that is the second ball, there itself the attacking stroke has come into play. You have the banana flick, you have this flick, and the rubber is becoming so fast and easy to play those strokes, which are even net level. So there, attacking starts from there. And how do you block an attacking stroke? There are various ways. One is blocking. Blocking is a kind of controlled stroke. It's a kind of a defensive stroke, but played from near the table, and it is to mute the attack. The table tennis is becoming so fast that it's now a game of attack and counter attack from near the table or away the table. Wherever you are, you find people attacking on any ball. So that's the reason. Now, how to counter an attacking stroke? The attacking strokes are normally the topspin now, or a flat kill. Now, the entire reply to this is changed from only blocking to counter spinning. So you have to use counter block, backhand spin or forehand spin is the thing that you have to develop. Yes, every time you may not be in a good position to do, but doesn't mean that you don't know, because when you play to play counter spin, you have to play with every position that you are in. You may be sometimes in good position. If you are in good position, maybe you can play the stroke with good power. If you're not in good position, you play a little safer stroke. That could be a half topspin or a slower topspin or a block. So just block is there so that you get into position, in a better position to counter attack. So there are two things, one is block and one is counter spin. These are the two options that you have to counter an attacking stroke.
You're the youngest guy here.
My name is Kushwagani. And what do you think India in Tokyo 2020?
Lovely, that's a very good question. Yes, Olympic is the biggest sport, and I'm sure table tennis is in Olympic since 1988. That's the first time that table tennis was included, and since then every year India has always had players who have qualified. In fact, last Olympics, India has the maximum qualified players for a number of four players qualified, which is a very good number. And our players, especially Sharad Kamal and Satyan and Harmit and Amal Rajis, are the four top ranked players who are in top 120, 130 of the world, and their performance in the coming tournaments will help us to qualify for the Olympics. And we are very hopeful, looking at the performance of our Indian players recently in the various international tournaments, our main team will qualify. So that's going to be a very good thing. We have a very good chance of at least two additional players qualifying through the qualifying rounds, which are going to start after January, and we'll probably have a clearer picture in the month of April. One more event that we have a good chance at where government is also focusing is the mixed doubles, because in the mixed doubles, Sharad and Manika partnering themselves, they won a bronze medal in the Asian Games. And as you say, Asian Games is dominated very strongly by the world players. And so this, that's another aspect that we are looking forward to. So looking at this, it's quite a good picture in this Olympic 2020 at Tokyo. However, the way we are planning, we are also looking and targeting at 2024 and 2028, and that's the way government is now thinking of is long-term planning, and I'm sure the future generation will definitely benefit with such kind of planning.
I think we had a lovely session. It was very insightful. These kids and the people who will watch this will benefit from, you know, your insights, your views on the spot. Thank you for joining us. It was a pleasure having you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.